Hello classmate, how are you all? So we had been studying chapter number 2. Today is the last class of chapter number 2. So last time we studied about communicable disease. Let's revise again. Then we will begin non-communicable disease. Okay, so what are communicable diseases? Diseases that can spread from one person to other person are called communicable diseases. They are spread, they are caused by germs, or you can say pathogen. How does germ spread communicable disease? Through three ways germ spread communicable disease. First is through direct contact with an infected person. Second is through dirty food and water. Third is through insect. Yes. And through direct contact with an infected person, TB, cold, measles occur. Through dirty food and water, cholera, typhoid occur. Through insect, malaria, dengue, these are other. And how to prevent ourselves from communicable disease? There are different ways. First is maintain personal hygiene and community hygiene. Point number two, keep immunization up to date. Means eat healthy fruit, vegetable, wash them, then eat fresh fruit, fresh food you should eat. You should not eat cold drink, burger, pizza. They do not improve your immunity. Wash your hand regularly, especially during cold and flu. Use antibiotics exactly as prescribed by doctor. Maintain social distancing. Yes, social distance is important. And drink clear water. And we should not allow water to collect in our homes or around our homes, because mosquito breed in stagnant water. And vaccination, the last way of protecting ourselves from communicable disease is vaccination. Vaccination is the use of a special substance. Vaccination is the use of a special substance called vaccine to prevent specific disease. And what is a vaccine? A vaccine is a substance that teaches the body's immunity system recognize and protect from against a disease. So all these topics we studied last time. Today we will begin the topic non-communicable diseases. Yes. What is a non-communicable disease? Last time I gave you introduction, but let's see again. And non-communicable diseases are diseases that cannot spread from one person to another person. Yes. These diseases cannot spread from person to person. And some diseases are chronic. Yes, some diseases can remain in your body for long period or maybe forever. So diseases that cannot spread from one person to another person are called non-communicable. Okay, now let's move on the next point. Okay kids, let's see the examples of non-communicable diseases. All these diseases are not given in your book. Only few diseases are given. We will study only those diseases which are given in your book. But if you want to write all these diseases, you can write. Examples of non-communicable diseases. As you can see on the screen, diabetes, yes, Parkinson's, Downey syndrome, cancer, heart disease, epilepsy, Tourette's, asthma, allergies, autism, arthritis, cerebral palsy, cystic fibrosis, multiple sclerosis. So these diseases are breast cancer, skin cancer, sickle cell, are non-communicable diseases. Generally, diabetes, cancer, heart disease, एज़मा, इन हिंदी भी से अस्थमा, एज़मा, एलर्जीज, आर्थराइटिस, ब्रेस्ट कैंसर, स्किन कैंसर, दीज डिजीजेज स्प्रेड. दीज डिजीजेज आर कॉमन डिजीज. एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ नॉन कम्युनिकेबल इज, राइट ओनली दीज नेम. आई एम स्पीकिंग, राइट यू दीज नेम. डायबिटीज, प्लीज राइट द स्पेलिंग ऑफ डायबिटीज, DIABETES. कैंसर, CANCER, CANCER. हार्ट डिजीज, HEART, हार्ट, DISEAS, हार्ट. एजमा, ASTHM, ASTHM. एलर्जीज, ALLERGIES. स्किन कैंसर, SKIN, स्किन कैंसर, CANCER. ब्रेस्ट कैंसर, BREST, ब्रेस्ट, CANCER. आर्थराइटिस, ARTHRITIS. सो वी विल स्टडी फ्यू डिजीजेज अमंग देम. ओके, नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. ओके किड्स, आई वॉन्ट टू आस्क यू अ क्वेश्चन. यस, आई वॉन्ट टू आस्क यू सिंपल क्वेश्चन. द क्वेश्चन इज, इफ यू will not eat healthy food, healthy vegetables, healthy fruit, then what will happen? You will suffer from some diseases. These diseases are known as deficiency diseases. These diseases are known as deficiency diseases. Okay, so our topic is deficiency diseases. Deficiency means shortage. Yes, shortage of disease. Deficiency disease. Please check out the spelling of deficiency, DEFICIENCY, DISEASES, deficiency. So I have shown you three columns on the screen. In first column I have written the name of disease, deficiency disease. In second column, the mid column, I have written the reason, and in last column I have written the name of some food and minerals, vitamins and minerals that you should eat to save yourself. So we will talk here about some vitamin disease. If you will not eat, there are vitamins like vitamin A, B, C, D, E, K. In your book only 4 vitamins are given. We have vitamin A, vitamin B1, vitamin C, vitamin D. So if you will not eat vitamin, then which disease can be possible? Please write down. So first disease name is night blindness. In first column, night blindness. The cause is vitamin A. Means if you will not eat those fruits and vegetables rich with vitamin A, you will suffer from night blindness. Yes, night blindness means you cannot see anything at night, or you cannot see, loss of vision, and sometimes complete loss of vision is also possible. So you should eat, which food you should eat which contain vitamin and mineral? Green leafy vegetables you should eat for vitamin A, papaya, carrot, mango, milk, butter, egg yolk you should eat for vitamin A. Okay. Vitamin B1. Next disease, you can see beriberi in next column. You can see the name of disease, beriberi. Beriberi is caused by vitamin B1 deficiency. Yes, due to shortage of vitamin B1, you will suffer from beriberi disease. Your muscles will become weak. Yes, in beriberi disease, your muscles become weak. So what should you eat? You should take milk. You should eat peas, cereals, green vegetables. Yes, peas, cereals, green vegetables, magic. Next is rickets. Rickets is caused by shortage of vitamin D. Rickets is deficiency disease, which is caused by the deficiency of vitamin D. Yes. Rickets disease. In this disease, your bones become soft and bent. Yes, bones become soft and bent. So you should eat milk and milk product. Yes, which food you should eat? Milk and milk product. Look the last column, milk and milk product. Okay, now point number 4, scurvy. Scurvy is the name of deficiency disease which is caused by the deficiency of vitamin C. Yes, deficiency means shortage. If you don't eat vitamin C, you will suffer from scurvy disease. Yes, if you don't eat vitamin C, you will suffer from scurvy disease. So you should eat sour thing like amla, orange, lemon, tomato. You should eat amla, orange, lemon, tomato. These food can protect you from vitamin C. These provide you vitamin C and protect you from scurvy disease. So during scurvy disease, bleeding from gums occur. Yes, bleeding from gums, you can see, won't takes longer time to heal. So you should eat vitamin C food like amla, orange, lemon, tomato. Okay. I'm giving you 10 seconds, please write down. So vitamin A rich food are green leafy vegetable, papaya, carrot, mango, milk, butter, egg yolk. That this protect you from night blindness. Vitamin B1 food are milk, peas, cereal, green vegetables. Protect you from beriberi disease. Vitamin D product are milk and milk product that protect you from rickets disease. Vitamin C product are amla, orange, lemon, tomato. That protect you from scurvy disease. I hope you understood. Now let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, I have written one line on screen. If you want to write, you can write it. If you don't want to write, then don't write. It is just for your information purpose I have written. It is just for your information purpose I have written. So non-communicable diseases are leading cause of death worldwide, accounting for 68% of total. Yes. According to WHO, WHO means World Health Organization, yes, which keep the data related to health, related to disease, keep the data related to health, related to disease, that 68% of total death, the reason behind it is non-communicable diseases, yes. Non-communicable diseases are the leading cause of death worldwide, accounting for 68% of people. Every year, 68% of total death are due to non-communicable disease. It means due to communicable disease, accident, people die less than in comparison to non-communicable disease. It means non-communicable diseases are spreading too much. It means people are not getting food. People are not getting healthy food. People are not eating healthy food. The people who are getting healthy food, they are not eating healthy food. They like to eat burger, pizza. Due to shortage of vitamins, these diseases are spreading. Many people have malnutrition problem. Malnutrition means deficiency of nutrients. Malnutrition means deficiency of nutrients. So these diseases are spreading. So now let's talk about few reason of non-communicable disease. What are the causes of non-communicable disease? Let's talk about these causes, then we will see some non-communicable disease. Let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, now let's talk about the reason of non-communicable diseases, causes of non-communicable disease. What are the reasons? I have written three main reasons. What are the main three causes of non-communicable diseases? Point number one, hereditary, hereditary, hereditary. Hereditary means passed from parents to child, yes. Suppose if your father or mother has allergy problem, suppose if your father or mother has allergy problem or obesity, heart disease, if your mother or father has obesity, heart disease, then it is possible that they can transfer from your parents to into you. These diseases can transfer from parents to children. Such diseases are called hereditary diseases. So non-communicable diseases are hereditary diseases. Yes, they can be hereditary. Environment, where you live or work. Yes, environment also causes non-communicable disease. Like nuclear power plant. If you are living around nuclear power plant or any factory, any chemical factory, then due to those chemicals, non-communicable disease can spread. If you are living near nuclear power plant, nuclear power plant release harmful chemicals, which can spread non-communicable disease. Yes. Next is lifestyle. Yes. How is your lifestyle? How is your habit? Smoking. If you smoke cigarette, then these diseases can spread. If you eat poor diet, yes, if your diet is not good. Poor diet means not eating healthy food, then these diseases can spread. Yes, and one more reason is tanning. Yes, one more reason is tanning. What is the meaning of tanning? TANNING. Tanning means making leather. Tanning means making leather. Yes. It can spread. Lack of exercise. If you don't do exercise, then these diseases can spread. Stress is also reason behind the non-communicable disease. Yes. Tension, it is also reason. So don't be stressed. There is one more meaning of word tanning is when your skin look dry, you see patches on skin due to poor lifestyle, which shows the poor health. Yes, tanning shows the poor health. Means patches on your skin. There are patches. Your skin is dry, not healthy. Rashes you can see on this skin. That is also the meaning of tan, which occur due to not eating, poor diet, drinking alcohol, smoking. So there are three reasons. What are the causes of non-communicable disease? What are the reason behind the non-communicable disease? Hereditary, environmental, and lifestyle. Hereditary means passed from parents to child. Environmental means where you live, how is your environment? If you are living near the chimney factory, near the chemical factory, nuclear power plant, these diseases can spread from these factories. Lifestyle, like smoking, drinking, poor diet, lack of exercise, emotional exercise, stress. I hope you understood. Now let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, let's see some non-communicable diseases. First disease is allergy. What is the meaning of allergy? Spelling ALLERGY, allergy. Allergy is defined as the abnormal or unusual response to a substance by human body is called allergy. Yes. If your body is responding to a substance, then it means you are suffering from allergy. Many people have different kind of allergy. One more definition is the harmful reaction to the external substance is known as allergy. The harmful reaction to external substance. Yes. When your body react to harmful external substance, and the reaction become harmful, then you suffer from allergy. So allergy is defined as the abnormal response. Abnormal response to a substance. Abnormal response to a substance. Or unusual response to a substance. It means your body responds to external substance. Your body responds to external substance. These substances are known as allergens. These substances are known as allergens. Maybe these substances may be anything like the smell of anything. Maybe soil. Maybe some kind of food. Maybe fast food. Yes. You can have any kind of allergy. You can have any kind of allergy. When your body behave abnormally, not behave normally with any substance. Maybe the substance may be like smell of anything, maybe the smell of perfume, maybe the smell of any food, maybe the soil. So it can be anything. So these sources, perfume, smell, soil, food, these external substances are known as allergen. These external substances are allergy. So what happens during allergy? What happens during allergy? You will see some patches. You will see some patches on the skin. These patches are very harmful. So what is allergy? Allergy is defined as the abnormal or unusual response to substance by human body is called allergy. Please write down. I am giving you 10 seconds. Okay, I hope that you have written. Now let's move on the symptoms of allergy. So as you can see the symptoms of allergy, have you ever seen such kind of red patches, red spot on the skin of someone? You might have seen red spot on the skin of someone. These red spots are showing that someone is suffering from allergy problem. Yes. Red patches, these red patches you can see, sometimes they can swollen. So these red patches may be on hand, body. Then you may suffer from itching problem also during, if you have red patches, then you can suffer from itching problem. These red patches are very dangerous. Yes, your body completely filled with red patches, red spot. So in this condition, what should you do? You should need to maintain personal hygiene. Yes, need to maintain personal hygiene. Take bath every day. Wash your clothes in boiled hot water. Yes. Wash your clothes, boiled hot water every day. Wear only one time, one dress. Do not wear next day the same dress. Wash it with hot water. It is non-communicable, but you need to maintain personal hygiene. Okay, I hope you understood. Now let's move on the next disease. Okay kids, next disease is obesity. Yes, next disease is obesity. Can you see the picture of a human man, human being? Can you see the picture of human being? Watch the picture carefully. What do you observe and tell me, what do you think? You can easily guess that the man is suffering from a disease which is known as obesity. So what is obesity? If you eat unhealthy food, if your eating habits are wrong, if you have bad habits of eating, then your weight can increase. If you are eating oil, ghee, fatty food too much, then this problem can happen. Look the shape and size of the man. He is so overweight. When your weight increase, when you become overweight, then that condition is called obesity. So what is obesity? The state of being overweight. The state of being overweight is called obesity. Yes. The state of being overweight is called obesity. Let's see the some reason behind it. Let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, as you can see the picture of a man, he's so overweight. What are the reasons? What are the bad habits? Because of unhealthy lifestyle and bad habits, a weight of human being increase. Like if you eat so much sweets, yes, sweets. Like ice cream you eat too much, chocolate you eat too much, then you can suffer from obesity disease. Chocolate and these sweet can also responsible for diabetes. Yes, sweets, if you are eating so much sweet, you can have diabetes problem. Junk food, yes, if you are eating cold drink, pizza, burger, kurkure, chips, then you can suffer from diabetes. If you don't do anything every day, just sit down and play all the time game in your mobile, game in watch TV and do nothing, and while eating and do no exercise, then you can have obesity problem. Yes. If you are drinking unhealthy drinks, then you can also suffer from obesity problem. Yes. So reason number one, eating sweets, 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 like ice cream. Tell me the spelling of ice cream. Tell me the spelling of ice cream. Chocolates, yes, tell me the spelling of chocolates. Tell me, if you don't know the spelling of chocolate, ask to your parents. Eating junk food, yes, junk food, JUNK, junk, FOOD food, JUNK, junk, FOOD. Eating junk food like burger, pizza. Yes, tell me the spelling of burger. Tell me the spelling of pizza. If you don't know, ask to your parents. I'm not going to tell you because I know you like to eat burger, you like to eat pizza. I'm not going to tell you the spelling of burger. Play the game, rest at home all the time. Just no exercise. Tell me the spelling of exercise. Yes, an unhealthy drink. If you are drinking cold drink, Mountain Dew, Pepsi, these are unhealthy drink, not good for health. Yes, these are unhealthy drink. So leave these and eat healthy food. Gain healthy lifestyle. Do exercise. No smoking. Smoking is not good. I hope you understood. Now let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, next disease is heart disease. Yes. Heart disease may be hereditary disease, as I said, hereditary, that pass from parents to children. Yes. During heart disease, your heart doesn't function properly. Sometime maybe you can suffer from heart attack. As you can see the picture of heart of a boy, they can be present at birth, heart disease can be present at birth. Sometime hole may be possible in heart. Due to hole in heart, you can suffer from heart disease. Yes. Heart disease, the one more reason behind it, heart disease is, if you are eating so much fatty food, not eating healthy food, yes. If you are not eating healthy food, then you can suffer from heart disease. Yes, if you are eating like so much oil, so much ghee, then you can have heart problem. If you are not doing exercise, yes. If you want to make your heart healthy, you should do yoga, you should do exercise, you should run sometime. Yes. Okay. This is the picture of our heart. You can see when vessels are those pipeline in our heart which transfer blood, when they become defective, when defective vessels also caused heart disease. You can see the picture of defective vessels. Can you see DEFECTIVE VESSELS? Defective vessels. When walls leak, walls. Can you see the picture of walls? Walls try to block the path of blood. Leaky walls, defective walls, holes in heart. These are the reason behind the heart. And unhealthy lifestyle, unhealthy food. I hope you understood. Now let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, next kind of disease is diabetes. D-I-A-B-E-T-E-S. 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 Yes, you can also suffer from diabetes. What are the reasons behind diabetes? Eating sweet food, sugar. If you are eating sugar or sugar product, sweet too much if you are eating, if you are drinking soda, if you are eating pizza, if you are not eating healthy food, then you can suffer from diabetes. What are the symptoms of diabetes? Weight loss, yes. During diabetes, your weight may lose. It is possible. Wound heals slowly. Next, wound, yes. If you injured, your wound takes so much time to heal. You feel so hungry, yes. During diabetes. And always feel thirsty. Yes, thirsty. Once there was a crow, he was so thirsty. That was thirsty. You feel so thirsty. Feeling hungry. Won't take so time. And frequent urination. Yes. Urination is so frequent. Urine. Urine pass from your body so frequent, so quickly. So what should you do in such case? Point number one. Don't eat unhealthy food, means don't drink soda, cold drink like Pepsi, don't drink Maza, Maza is not good for health, yes. They contain nothing, only 1% fruit, they contain nothing. So don't eat such kind of thing. Eat healthy food. Eat fruits. Do everyday bicycling. Yes. Ride bicycle. Play football. Sometime you should play football. Take the treatment from doctor. Yes. Take the antibiotics prescribed by doctor. Can you see the picture of doctor? Can you see the picture of medicine? Can you see the picture of bicycle? Drink water as much as possible. Healthy lifestyle can prevent you from diabetes. I hope you understood. Now let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, as you can see on the screen, I have written one line. Diabetes and arthritis may be caused when a part of the body fails to function properly. Diabetes and arthritis may be caused when a part of the body fails to function properly. Yes. Suppose if any body part is not functioning properly, if your any body part is not working properly, then you can suffer from diabetes problem. Yes, my dear kid, you can suffer from diabetes problem. An arthritis problem. Arthritis is joint pain, joint related problem. Joint ache. You cannot stand properly when you have joint problem. Arthritis. Okay? Arthritis is related to joint. So, diabetes and arthritis may be caused when a part of the body fails to function properly. Yes, not working any body part then you can suffer from diabetes and arthritis. Please write down the line. I'm giving you 10 seconds. Okay, kids. So now you know about diabetes. Let's see some more prevention. Let's move on to the next point. Okay, kids, smoking and drinking. We should not smoke. No smoking, yes. You can see the symbol of not smoking. No drinking is good. Yes. No smoking, no drinking. You can protect yourself. How to protect from non-communicable disease? Smoking and drinking. No smoking. Do not smoke cigarette. Do not smoke anything. Do not drink alcohol, wine. Yes, they are not good for health. Really, they are very bad for health. My dear kids, they are really bad for health. So, stay away from smoking and drinking. And you can suggest to your parents that smoking and drinking is not good for health. They are injurious for health. If someone smoke or someone drink, you can tell them, do not smoke, do not drink. Then they are not good for them. So avoid them. Yes. Avoid them. They can also generate cancer. Yes. Smoking, drinking can generate cancer. The cancer can be related to mouth cancer, lung cancer, skin cancer. And by smoking, if you smoke so much, if any person smoke, he or she can suffer from lungs related problem. Yes, breathing problem. Breathing difficulty problem, yes, breathing difficulty. So stay away. I hope you understood. Now let's move on to the next point. Exercise and poor way diet. Exercise and poor diet. Yes, as I said that if you don't do exercise and you are eating so much, you can see the picture of ice cream. You can see the picture of ice cream, you can see the picture of sweet, you can see the picture of samosa. If you don't do exercise and you eat only ice cream, pizza, sweet, then you can suffer from obesity. And what is obesity? The state of being overweight. Yes, what is obesity? The state of being overweight is called obesity. If your diet is not good, poor diet, so avoid poor diet, eat healthy food. Poor diet means not eating healthy food, eating unhealthy food. Which are the unhealthy food? Sweet, junk food, and drink. Drink means cold drink, chocolate drink. These are unhealthy. So stay away from these. If you take poor diet, means if you are eating fatty food, oily food so much, unhealthy diet if you are eating, you can suffer from heart disease. And these non-communicable disease can also be hereditary, related to environment, poor lifestyle. So change your lifestyle. Every day do yoga, exercise. You can run bicycling you can do. You can run. Do hard work. Do physical work. Yes. So in this way you can protect yourself from diabetes, non-communicable diseases, allergy, maintain personal hygiene. I hope you understood. Now let's move on to the last point. Okay kids, it's time to ask question from you. Question number one, write the name of some non-communicable diseases. Yes, write the name of some non-communicable diseases. Diabetes, cancer, heart disease, asthma, allergy, arthritis, skin cancer, breast cancer. Yes, these are non-communicable diseases. Diabetes, cancer, heart disease, asthma, allergy, arthritis, skin cancer, breast cancer. Other diseases are Down syndrome, epilepsy, Down syndrome, epilepsy, Parkinson, cystic fibrosis, cerebral palsy, these are the bulimia, these are the diseases. Next question, question number two. What is allergy? Yes, what is allergy? A-L-L-E-R-G-Y, allergy. Allergy is defined as, allergy is the abnormal response to substance. Yes, the abnormal or unusual response to a substance by human body. Allergy is defined as the abnormal or unusual response to a substance by human body. Yes, allergy is defined as the abnormal or unusual response to a substance by human body is called allergy. Okay, and these external sources, substances are known as allergy. What is obesity? The state of being overweight. What is obesity? The state of being overweight is called obesity. Yes, the state of being overweight. If you have bad habits, means if you are eating sweets, junk food, drink, then you can suffer from obesity. Question number four. Write the causes of diabetes and arthritis. Write the cause of diabetes and arthritis. Diabetes occur due to eating fatty food, unhealthy food, not doing exercise, and arthritis. It may be caused when a body part fails to function properly. Diabetes and arthritis may be caused when a part of body fails to function properly. So today the chapter, we have completed chapter number 2. Now we will meet with a new chapter in next class. Please practice at home. Read all these diseases. Don't try to memorize. Try to understand. Try to understand. Don't try to memorize. Okay? Now we will meet in the next class. Till then, goodbye.